Around 80 to 90% of UK adults drink alcohol. So in this week's video, we're looking at how long it takes for your body to break down alcohol and how it breaks it down. We're also going to be looking at the limits of alcohol that you should be drinking up to, and also what can happen if you're drinking over the limit. So what are the long-term health implications of doing this and how we can reduce our alcohol intake. Now, just a really important quick note before we begin the video. If you found this video because you've had a quick drink of beer or wine or whatever, and you're thinking of driving, then please do not drive. Do not drive if you've had any amount of alcohol. I'm gonna say that right from the start. Be responsible, because any amount of alcohol can affect your reflexes and it can affect your safety and other people's safety. That is the most important thing. Please be responsible, and I'm gonna discuss all of this as well throughout the video. Okay, so now let's begin with some science. First of all, how is alcohol broken down in your system? How is it metabolized, in other words? So, if you're having some alcohol on an empty stomach, around 20% of it is absorbed directly through your stomach and goes straight into your bloodstream. Some of the alcohol in your stomach is actually broken down by an enzyme known as alcohol dehydrogenase, and it changes it to something called acetaldehyde. Now, acetaldehyde is also a toxic component, just like alcohol, but sometimes you might notice when you've had a drink of alcohol, you might feel a bit sick, you might feel like your heart's beating a bit more, you might feel a bit red and look a bit red. That is due to that compound that's created. So you may now be thinking, well, Abraham, what happens to the remaining 80% of the alcohol? Well, the remaining 80% goes into your small intestine, it's absorbed into your bloodstream, and your bloodstream travels it to the rest of your body or to your liver. And in the liver, around 90% of it is broken down into acetaldehyde, the same compound we were just talking about earlier, and this happens in three different ways. So the first pathway is what we call the MEOS pathway, and we have these things called microsomes within the liver, and they contain an enzyme which we call cytochrome P450. The cytochrome P450 enzyme oxidizes the alcohol. The second pathway is in peroxisomes, where an enzyme called catalase again oxidizes the alcohol. And the third pathway, which is actually the most common pathway, is in the cytosol of the liver, where the enzyme that we spoke about earlier, alcohol dehydrogenase, is also there, which again oxidizes the alcohol. So I hope this bit isn't too sciencey, but I'm trying to make it as simple as possible just so you've got a rough understanding of how it works. So we've looked at the three pathways in the liver and the alcohol has been oxidized. The next step is we've got something called aldehyde dehydrogenase, which then changes that acetaldehyde to something called acetate. And acetate either stays within your liver and makes fatty acids or cholesterol, or it travels in your bloodstream to other parts of the body, which is then changed to carbon dioxide and water. And finally, just under 10% of the alcohol leaves your body via your lungs, from your kidneys, or in your sweat. That's why sometimes when you're drinking alcohol, you can smell it on your breath, and also you need to pee a lot. So the next question is, well, how long does this whole process take? Well, on average, about 10 minutes after you finish your alcoholic beverage, about 50% of the alcohol is absorbed into your bloodstream. And after about 30 to 60 minutes, it's fully absorbed into your bloodstream. And in terms of how long it takes to burn these units, it takes on average about 1 hour to get rid of 1 unit of alcohol, or 8 grams of alcohol. But stop right there, because it's not as simple as that. There are many different variables that come into play that actually affect these numbers that I've just given you now. And we're gonna talk about them as well. But before we go into that, I just wanna say this again. Please, 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 if you've had any alcohol to drink, do not drive. If you're watching this video for that reason, please, if you've had any alcohol to drink, please do not drive. Be responsible. Any alcohol, any level of it, can affect your reflexes, okay? And it can cause direct harm to you or someone else, and it's just not worth it. So please do not drink drive. No matter how little alcohol you've had, please do not drink drive. Let's continue. So moving on to the different variables that can affect how the alcohol is absorbed and how it's broken down. You've probably heard the saying, never drink on an empty stomach, and this is totally correct. You know, when you're drinking alcohol or any alcohol drink, you really want to have a bit of food. I usually say a fistful of food. It can be anything, carbohydrates, proteins. Any form of food is going to be really helpful And it's gonna affect how much alcohol we absorb, because when you've had some food, you're gonna have more of these digestive juices flowing in your stomach. And what you're gonna have in there, you're gonna have that enzyme that we spoke about earlier, alcohol dehydrogenase. It's gonna be in there and it's gonna help with the breakdown process right from the start when it gets into your stomach. Another variable that you need to take into account is genetics. If you're female, generally speaking, you have less of this alcohol dehydrogenase that we've spoke about. Having less of that is gonna mean that you're actually gonna absorb more alcohol into your system, and it's gonna require less alcohol to have an effect on you, unlike males who generally have more alcohol dehydrogenase. Now, another variable that you need to take into account is the type of alcohol that you're drinking. For example, if you're drinking something that's carbonated, that's fizzy, that's bubbly, like champagne, for example, that can absorb into your bloodstream a lot quicker than something that's still. Also, the other thing that you need to think about is concentrations. If you're having something high in volume or high in concentration of alcohol, again, it can absorb much faster into your bloodstream. Now, moving on to the next variable, how hydrated are you? If you're someone that's quite dehydrated, the alcohol concentration is gonna rise a lot quicker to someone who is quite hydrated, who have had enough water, who've had 6 to 8 glasses of water a day, who are quite hydrated. That's why it's so important, if you do drink any alcohol, that you remain hydrated as well. Your body composition and size can also affect how much water you can carry. Also, for example, if you have quite a lot of fat on your body, this can also cause an increase in the absorption of alcohol. And if you drink quite regularly, you build something called alcohol tolerance. So we looked at the different pathways of how alcohol is broken down, and what happens in alcohol tolerance is we have an increased production of the cytochrome P450 enzyme, which we spoke about earlier, and this then causes a faster breakdown of alcohol, and it also causes dependence though. Alcohol dependence is a big issue. Now, with that in mind, we then need to talk about liver damage, because this is a really important thing that we need to discuss. We've discussed how important the liver is for breaking down alcohol, but if you're drinking more than the recommended alcohol limit of 14 units per week, you can get liver damage, and the liver damage is going to mean that you're going to break down that alcohol a lot slower. So what does this mean? Well, it means that you're going to have more alcohol in your bloodstream for longer periods, so you're going to feel unwell for longer. It's going to take a lot longer for you to break down that alcohol and come back to normal. And also, you can then develop liver problems such as liver cirrhosis, fatty liver, and even liver cancer. So this is an important thing that we need to discuss. So the bottom line is this: the rate of alcohol breakdown is unique to your body. There's no one size fits all, and there are so many different variables in play, such as your body composition, how much you've had to eat, what you're drinking, when you're drinking, so many different variables. So it's absolutely impossible to give an actual factual based answer that it's going to take this long to break down, it takes this long to absorb. It's very, very difficult to do something like that. It is unique to you, which is why it's so important, and I'm going to say this again, and you might not like me for saying this, but if you've had any alcohol to drink, do not drive. That is the most important thing. Please be responsible, look after yourself and look after others, and be safe. That's the most important thing in this video that I want you to take home. So now let's move on to recommended alcohol units and actually when to seek medical advice if you're drinking too much. So here in the UK, the recommended alcohol limit is 14 units per week for men and women. And we're looking at this spread over at least 3 days, and also the importance of alcohol-free days during that week to give your liver time to break down that alcohol. Remember, we know how the whole process works. So it's important that you're getting those alcohol-free days to give your liver time to breathe and get back to normal. Okay, now if you're wondering how many units are in each drink, I will leave a link in the description below to a really good unit alcohol calculator, so click in the description below to see it. I've also got a little infographic that will come up here, so if you want to look at that as well, pause the video and have a good look at it. Now, we all have different drinking habits, and sometimes it can actually have a negative effect on our lives. Now, if you're worried at all or concerned that you might be drinking too much, there's actually a really good audit that I found as well, which I will leave a link to in the description below. Feel free to check it out if you're concerned at all. Now, another way to live a healthy lifestyle is to reduce your alcohol intake. We know this. We know that alcohol increases your heart rate. We know that it dampens down your nervous system. We know that it dehydrates you. And we know that if large amounts of alcohol are drank during a short period of time, it can be toxic and cause a lot of problems. And as well as the short-term effects, regularly drinking too much alcohol can have long-term effects too. So increasing the risk of high blood pressure, liver disease, pancreas, pancreatitis, strokes, dementia, infertility, and 7 different types of cancers. So to reduce these risks, it's recommended that you don't drink alcohol regularly. And again, we're sticking to a limit of 14 units per week, at least spread over 3 days, and we're looking at alcohol-free days. That's really, really important that we do that as well. And reducing our alcohol intake can have many, many health benefits. So for example, we're gonna get better sleep, we're gonna get better mental health, better mood, better concentration, better skin, weight loss, less likely to have heartburn and indigestion. So there's so many health benefits that we can get from reducing our alcohol intake. And I know that when drinking alcohol has become a routine for a lot of people, it can be very difficult to get out of that mindset because it's just become part of their normal routine. But there are things that you can do that can help. So tip number one is to know your limits. Like I mentioned earlier, it's recommended that both men and women drink no more than 14 units regularly a week. So this is equivalent of 6 pints of beer or 6 medium glasses of wine. Now, different drinks have different alcohol contents, which vary from brand to brand. So a really useful way to keep track of what you're drinking is to use an app or a unit calculator. For example, a good app which I think is really helpful is DrinkAware Track and Calculate Units app, but there are many more, so do a bit of research if you don't like this one. The second tip that I want to give you is plan ahead. Look, sometimes people drink alcohol after stressful days. So if you know, for example, on a Wednesday, you always have a stressful day at work and you end up drinking quite a lot of alcohol after that, think about it and plan ahead. It's all about making these achievable goals and doing these small things that can make a big difference. So plan ahead, think to yourself, actually, on that day where I've had a stressful day, I'm gonna go for a run, I'm gonna go to the gym, I'm gonna do a hobby, something different to distract you so you're not becoming dependent on the alcohol on those stressful days. Moving on to tip number 3, change your beverages to low alcohol or no alcohol beverages. This is a great way of reducing the number of alcohol units we have per week, and also it has much less calories in it and you can enjoy that great refreshing taste that you might like. And lastly, tip number 4, don't be afraid to seek help. Look, if you've done the alcohol unit calculation and you know that you're drinking a lot more than that, if you've done the audit and you know that you're drinking a lot more than the recommended amount, and it's affecting your lifestyle, it's affecting your mood, it's affecting your relationship with other people, then seek medical attention. Speak to a healthcare professional. There are also lots of charities available for this as well, and I'm going to leave loads of information about this in the description below. So if you're interested, please do check it out. And remember, healthcare professionals are there to help you. No one will judge you. We're always willing to listen. So please just contact your healthcare professional and seek for some help. Thank you for watching this video. I really hope that you found this information helpful. You now know how alcohol is absorbed in the body. You now know the different variables of how it's broken down. You now know all about cytochromes and how the liver works and all the scientific stuff. And you've become a bit of an alcohol pro. You know about how many units to have and how many units you shouldn't have, and also the risk factors of having too much alcohol. So you've become a bit of an alcoholic beverage pro now. Tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, but please remember, I'm going to say it again, if you've watched this video because you've had a drink and you're thinking of driving, please do not. Be responsible. Remember that any amount of alcohol can affect your reflexes and it can be a danger for yourself and other people. So please be responsible. If you've had any alcohol to drink, please do not drive. Thank you for watching this video. As I always say, always remember that you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.